I'm not ready to be just another of your mistakes. I can't seem to drown you out long enough. I fell victim to the sound of your love. You're like a song that I ain't ready to stop.
Hi, this is Freddy Sheed doing a rig rundown for Drummers Only. We're at the Barrowlands in Glasgow, night two of two. Yeah, just wanted to take a second to run you guys through my kit and yeah, have a little geek out. So the shells are Gretsch USA Customs. I got them kind of custom built from the factory. Usually the bass drums would come out as by 16, but because I wanted that kind of OG vintage thing, I got everything cut down to by 14. And they gave me like a couple, so I've got a 20 as well. But yeah, for this gig, I'm playing a 22. It's a 22 by 14, 12 by 8, and 16 by 16. And on the snare drum, I've got a 6.5 Gretsch Brooklyn chrome over brass with like the 302s, which I don't know, I think I've got them on my broadcaster and they're pretty good at just keeping the sound. It's just like a wider sound, I guess. On the cymbals, we've got, I play Istanbul, Agop. Always go a little bit darker for my sound, but I'm just finding on pop gigs, going a little bit darker means you can hide behind a lead vocal a bit easier. From left to right, we've got some Agop signature 15-inch hi-hats. Super kind of old K-esque, they feel pretty Gad-like. I'm a diehard Steve Gadd fan, so any opportunity to try and get slightly close to him, I'm always down with. On the left side, we've got a traditional thin crash. They mellow so quickly and sound cohesive. That's sounding really good. Kind of quick decay, doesn't really get in the way, but still feels like you're hitting a cymbal, you know, it's not too thin and jazzy, it's nice and kind of opens up really well. The main ride we've got is a 30th anniversary 24 Agop, which you're gonna pull it off. I mean, like absolute dream. Kind of feels good, like stick definition, but still dark and kind of like gets out the way quick, but I tend to find myself crashing on it a lot more than I thought, but yeah, that's gonna be even greater in a few years too, I think. And yeah, at far right, which as you can see has had a bit of a battering already, is a 22 Mel Lewis, which I don't know, it sounds like a 60s drum break encapsulated in a cymbal. Just loads of wash and kind of just occupies the right amount of space before it disappears again. You know, the profile of it's really kind of like bow-like, which is a dream, really. With drum heads, we've got ourselves a Remo Power Stroke 3 Clear on the bass drum, Coated Ambassador on the snare. I mean, that tends to vary depending on the gig. I'm a big fan of the Vintage A as well, but in a room like this, and where you're wanting to bring a little light and shade to a kind of dark vintage sounding drum kit, the Ambassador works a treat. On the snare, I use these snare weights that kind of simulate the feeling of a wallet. That's kind of been a staple part of my snare sound for years now. And vintage Ambassador coateds on top and bottom of both toms. And I don't know, there's a certain magic about putting two of the same on. They kind of cancel each other out and you don't have to use you know, your year's supply of gaffer tape to make the drums sound the way you want. In signature kind of gluten-free manner, I've gone for DW 6000s just because they look great. Just like manageability, like they seem to sit just as good as a 9000. We've had no hardware breakages, touch wood. I love mounting a rack tom on a snare stand. Don't know if many of you know this, but if you are getting a bit too much ring out of your rack tom, if you just tighten that stand a little bit and choke the head, you can make it sound really cohesive quite quickly. So yeah, DW 6000 hi-hat stand, DW 9000 bass drum pedal. Electronics world, we've got the old faithful Roland SPD SX, and just a couple of triggers. KT10, which is like a e-kick pedal, which feels kind of old school still. I mean, it's pretty pretty cool invention, but don't have to dial it in. Almost feels a little bit better than my real bass drum. And just a Roland dual trigger on the snare top. I think we're only using it for a single sound, but it's good to have the option. All electronics world takes patch change automation from our playback rig. Throughout the set, some sounds may get muted as we play through, and patches obviously banks of different sounds. Lewis's music's quite unique with the synthetic drum sound, so it's good to have options, and having the playback rig change your settings for you means that you kind of don't have to even think about it. It just feels like playing another instrument on the drum kit. And yeah, also removes the responsibility of me forgetting to change a patch, which has been known in my time. So for sticks with Lewis, I'm using Vic Firth 5B. I used to play thinner sticks, but then I started hearing a difference in actual sound. I tend to think about volume laterally instead of just a sort of up and down level thing. So like, volume to me is like occupying space. And I find the 5B gives me an extra kind of width to my sound that I can't really find anywhere else. This is kind of my vanilla, and I've been sticking with it, but yeah. Huge thank you to Gretsch, Remo. Yeah, shout out to Joe Cox, Vic, and Istanbul Agop have been pretty special. And massive shout out to Protection Racket too for keeping all of these drums cased and safe.